Welcome all of you in online teaching learning process. We have started paper number 7 in organic chemistry, in which we have started unit number 1, coordination chemistry. And in our last video we have seen details about the terms regarding ligand, coordination number, and in this video we will see what is the coordination sphere and effective atomic number. So we will see coordination sphere. So in the case of coordination sphere, which represents coordination number or represents secondary valency, or which is the inner sphere or non-ionizable sphere. So according to Alfred Werner, inner sphere of attraction of a metal is called coordination sphere. It is constituted by metal atom or ion and ligands. Ligands are strongly held by the central metal atom or ion in this sphere. Hence, they are non-ionizable. Therefore, it retains identity even in solution. Generally, type of bonding in inner sphere is coordinate covalent type of bonding. The coordination sphere is separated by a square bracket from the rest of the complex. Example, potassium ferrocyanide K4FeCN6, copper tetraamine. Coordination sphere is pictorially shown in figure below. So in case of CONH3CL3, cobalt is surrounded by 6 ammonia and 3 chlorines. So here coordination sphere consists of 3 cobalt surrounded by 6 ammonias. So this is a non-ionizable sphere because there is a strong bonding takes place between ammonia and cobalt 3 plus ion, so which represents secondary valency. So coordination number of cobalt is 6. So coordination sphere simply represents secondary valency or coordination number of the central metal ion, and which is always fixed. So in this case, coordination sphere cobalt is surrounded by 4 ammonia and 2 chlorine because coordination number of cobalt is 6. Then we will see effective atomic number. So effective atomic number concept, this rule is given by English chemist N.V. Sedgwick, and effective atomic number EAN is the total number of electrons in metal atom or ion atomic number plus the electrons gained from ligands. So effective atomic number is the atomic number of a noble gas. Therefore, effective atomic number decides stability of coordination compound. If a coordination compound follow effective atomic number rule, then it is a stable one, and if it does not obey effective atomic number rule, then that coordination compound is a unstable one. So according to Sedgwick, effective atomic number represented as effective atomic number Z minus X plus Y, where Z means atomic number of the central metal ion, then X the number of electrons lost during the formation of the metal ion from its atom. X means number of electrons lost during the formation of the metal ion from its atom, while Y represents number of electrons donated by the ligands, that is contribution of ligand. So in the case of FeCN6 4-, iron oxidation state is a +2, because in this complex iron shows +2 oxidation state, because there is a CN6 and out of the square bracket there is a -4, so there is a +2 oxidation state. Atomic number of iron is 26. So in this case the equation becomes 2, atomic number 26 minus number of electrons lost, how many electrons, that is 2 electrons, plus 6 times that is a coordination number of 6 coordination number of central metal and iron. So each ligand contribute 2 electrons. So 6 into 2, that is 12. So overall summation is a 36, which is the atomic number of krypton, which is a noble gas. So it complex obeys effective atomic number satisfactorily. So in the case of effective atomic number rule, the total number of electrons linked with the central metal atom or ion in a complex plus the electrons donated by the ligand is known as a effective atomic number. So another example, effective atomic number of the central metal atom in a complex can be easily calculated by using the formula Z minus oxidation number plus 2 times coordination numbers. So Z is the atomic number of the central metal atom, ON is the oxidation number of the central metal atom, same formula which we have seen in the previous slide. Cn is the coordination number of the central metal atom. A stable complex is formed if the effective atomic number is equal to the atomic number of the next noble gas. So in this case, iron is surrounded by 5 carbonyl groups, FeCO5. So here we make the calculation. Iron having atomic number 26 minus oxidation number of iron, so here oxidation number of iron is 01 plus 2 times coordination number. So iron is surrounded by 5 Cu, so coordination number of iron is a 5. So overall summation becomes to 26 plus 10, that is 36 1, so which is the atomic number of next noble gas, krypton. So it effectively obeys effective atomic number rule. Then another example, CrCO6, effective atomic number Z minus ON plus 2 times Cn, that is 24 minus 0 plus 2 times 6, 36, which is the atomic number of krypton. So rule, effective atomic number is satisfactorily obeyed. Then another example, cadmium EN twice Cl twice. Cadmium having atomic number 48 minus oxidation number of cadmium in this complex is minus 2 plus 2 times coordination number. Ethylene diamine is a bidentate ligand, so it contribute 2 into 4, that is 4 attachments of nitrogen atoms takes place here. So total 46 plus 8, 54, which is the atomic number of xenon. So it also satisfactorily obeys effective atomic number rule and stable one. Then in case of CO3 plus ion, CONH3 6 3 plus is calculated as follows. We will see some calculations. Cobalt having atomic number 27, it has 26 electron, but in this complex CO having 3 plus oxidation state, so 27 minus 3, 24 electrons, and 6 ammonia contribute 12 electrons. So effective atomic number of CO3 plus ion is, from this all calculations, it becomes 36, and it obeys effective atomic number rule. So these are the examples for that is along with cobalt, that is a chromium, then iron, FeCO5, recently we have seen, then NiCO4, cadmium, tetramine, and platinum Cl6. Then one by one we will see. Iron having atomic number 26, so in this complex K4FeCn6, oxidation state is a 2 plus, so electron lost in ion formation is 2 and electron given by ligand is a 12. So with respect to formula, it obeys effective atomic number rule, that is 36. Similarly in case of cobalt, with the all the calculations, it is a 36, so it also obeys effective atomic number rule. Then another example, NiCO4, oxidation state of the central metal ion is 0, electron lost in ion formation is also 0 and electron given by 4 electrons is 8. So overall summation 36 also obeys effective atomic number rule. Then another example for copper, zinc, palladium, platinum, it obeys effective atomic number rule. But in case of chromium, that is chromium NH3 6 3 plus, the oxidation state of the central metal ion is 3 plus, electron lost in ion formation is also 3 and electron given by ligand is 12, so overall summation is 35, so it does not obey effective atomic number, so it is an unstable compound. So along with chromium, some iron compounds and nickel compounds which does not obey effective atomic number rule, so they are unstable in nature. So these are about the effective atomic number calculations. So thank you all of you for listening this video.